We are in the third lecture in understanding the basics of costing. Now, myself Vishnuvardhani. We have seen to these contents in the last two lectures. In this lecture, we'll see the examples for the classification based on elements, traceability and variability, and also we'll look into functional and classification based on association with product in this lecture. The classification is the most fundamental thing in costing. So this is one type of classification which I took in the net as the picture was good. So we saw yesterday on the first, this one and this one. So this two we saw in detail, and this we started, and I gave you a problem for completion. We'll complete this and the other things for today. So based on elements or natural classification, you have classified the cost as material cost, labor cost and expenses. I hope you remember. So in that, we can again classify based on traceability as direct and indirect, direct labor, direct materials, direct expenses, and indirect labor, indirect material, indirect expenses. These are called the elements of cost. So if, when asked for elements, you should not do this labor, material and expenses alone. These are also included in the elements of cost. That is what I wanted to stress here. So when you are asked to classify based on elements of cost, you have to do based on traceability as well as on the nature. So these are the elements of cost. As I already mentioned, this elements is all these classification are elements, and the another word for indirect material, labor and expenses are overheads. So this we saw in the last lecture. Next, I asked you to classify based on as direct or indirect alone. I hope you would have classified based on nature also. So this is the classification based on elements of cost. Have you done that? If you have not done it, please pause it here and try to find the classification based on nature and traceability, and then go to the next slide. So now I hope you have completed. So the first one is material. In material, it is given as 27,000. So by nature, it is easy to classify this material cost. But based on traceability, it is not given what type of material it is. If it is a spinning mill and if purchase of cotton is given, purchase of material cotton is given, then you can take it as direct material cost. But here, since it is mentioned only as material, we cannot go for a conclusion based on traceability. So it may be direct or indirect. But if it is particularly given fiber cost for a spinning industry, fiber purchase cost, then it is surely a direct material cost. If it is a lubricating oil purchase for a spinning industry, then it is an indirect cost. So from this particular, you cannot find whether it is direct or indirect, but you can find whether it is what it is already given as material cost. So there is no trouble in the classification. So the first one, the answer is direct or indirect material cost. Now let us go to the second particular. So it is factory rent. So the factory rent, the amount is 12,000, and factory rent, why is it classified as expense? It is not a material, it is not a material, it is not a physical substance you're paying for. It is not for any service of some person, human effort you are paying. So if when you can't classify in those things, then it is an expense. We saw this yesterday. So, and it is cannot be directly related to any product or any process. So it is an indirect cost. So the answer is indirect expense. Next is wages. Wages is 14,000. So wages is paid for human effort. So it is easy to understand that it is a labor cost. But how can you tell it as direct or indirect? Here it is given as direct. Can you tell how it is direct? The term wages mean that it is paid on some basis of hourly basis or piece basis. So it is traceable. So it is classified as direct. So the answer for this third particular is direct labor cost. Wages is a direct labor cost. Whenever it is wages, it is a direct labor cost. And we'll go next to the fifth item, salaries. It is also a labor cost. Salary is paid to some human effort. So I don't think you will have difficulty in the natural classification. It is labor cost. But you cannot trace whether the supervisor has worked for 40s count or 20s count, whether he is working for men's or women's or which item. It is the common, whatever the line is in a spinning mill or in a processing or in a garment industry, supervisor, manager do not work for some product. Their salary does not change based on the output that is produced. So it is an indirect labor cost. Here it is indirect. IL is the answer here. So next is direct. So we now go to the fourth item, depreciation. So do you remember on the first day I told on cost and capital cost? In the second lecture, I told you on capital cost. When you purchase some machinery, you should not take, it is a capitalized cost, and you should not take into account for calculating the costs of the machinery purchase, land purchase, building construction costs and all. But depreciation of the machinery is to be included because you are producing something and it depreciates for that period. You are for that particular period you are processing 3 or 4 counts and there is a depreciation of machinery that is happening. So the depreciation has to be accounted. So that depreciation, there are many methods for finding depreciation, which is not a part of our syllabus. That depreciation cost is an expense, but it cannot be raised for any particular product. So it is an indirect cost and it is not paid for some human effort or some material purchase. So it is an expense. So the answer is indirect expenses. Next is direct expenses. It is the term itself, they have clearly given the particular as direct expenses. So there is no need for any identification. It is already direct expenses. The answer is direct expenses, directly given in the particulars itself. Now we'll come to the last one, insurance. Hope you have found it right. It is an expense as it is not paid for any material purchase or it is not paid for some human effort that is put in. It is for something else. And it is not traceable based on any product, so it is indirect. So the answer is indirect expenses. You can tell it as IE, indirect expenses. This direct expenses as DE, this is the short form that is commonly used. This is IL, this is IE, this is, hope you have found, this is DL, this is IE, and this you don't know based on traceability. So it is a material cost, maybe direct or indirect. So hope you have understood this. Now with this, I'm going to the next slide. So the next classification we already saw yesterday on the graphs of as the classification based on variability, three types of under this classification, fixed, variable and semi-variable cost. We have seen this graph. So for the fixed cost, I want you to see this graph. There is even for zero production, there is some cost involved. It does not start with zero at all, fixed cost. Some difference is there even for a zero production. For variable cost, it will start with zero always and it increases and it follows some constant ratio, a constant ratio proportionate to the activity or the number of products produced, volume produced. Semi-variable cost does not start with zero because it has fixed component as well as variable component. So, and it is not fixed also. As the activity changes, it will change, but it does not start with zero. So, these are the differences between variable, fixed and semi-variable cost. With this, I gave you this problem yesterday for you to work out. I hope you have done it. Have you completed? If not, please try to do this. try to do some identification. Now I will tell you a logical method for finding the classification. So first, the same is given. This is your problem. This first three columns are already given in the problem. These three columns, it is already given. So I have rewritten it as total cost. The item that is given as total cost. They have not mentioned whether it is variable or fixed cost. So we are writing it as total cost for 1000 units is the first column, and the total cost for this 2000 units is the second column. So from this, they have already given for 1000 units and double what is the cost. So from that, now we can find the variable cost for 1000 units. First is the total cost, second is the total cost for 2000 units. So the difference in the number of units is 2000. So now we are going to find the cost for the variation that has happened from this to this, the variation or variable cost that has occurred for the extra production of 1000 units. This column is treated as A, this column is treated as B, and now the variable cost is C for production of 1000 units, which is B minus A. So 2000 units minus 1000 units production is the extra cost incurred for the 1000 units. So in this we have V minus A, 10,000 minus, I'm sorry, 1 lakh minus 50,000, which is 50,000 here. Next, direct labor, 56,000 minus 28,000 is 28,000. Then rent for the factory, for 75,000 minus 75,000, which is 0. Power cost, 50,000 minus 35,000 is 15,000, and maintenance cost, 26,000 minus 17,000 is 9,000. So this is the variable cost. So when the variable cost is 0, there is some mistake here. You don't see this column. I will tell what this column is. So with this, this is the variable cost now for producing 1000 units. Total cost for producing 1000 units. So the first column, now A is the total cost for producing 1000 units and C is the variable cost for producing 1000 units. When you are A and C are the same, the difference between A, total cost minus variable cost is your fixed cost. So the total cost is 50,000 and the variable cost is also 50,000. So there is no fixed cost involved in direct material. So it is 0. Fixed cost is 0. Now second row, direct labor. You have again for direct labor, there is no difference for the first 1000 total, 1000 total cost minus variable cost is your fixed cost. That is A minus C. A minus C, 28,000 minus 28,000 is 0. Next is rent for factory. Here, whether you have, there is no variable cost at all. So the total is itself the fixed cost. There is no variable component here. So 75,000 minus 0 is 75,000. Next is power cost. Power cost, 35,000 minus 15,000 is 20,000, which is the fixed component, and the maintenance cost, total cost is 17,000 minus the variable cost is 9,000, which is 8,000. So this is the fixed cost here. So when you have fixed component and variable component both, then it is variable cost. So here it is, first one is totally variable cost, no fixed component, fixed component 0, variable component alone is there, so it is variable cost. It's right actually, so it is variable cost, VC, variable cost. Next, again no fixed cost, only variable component is there, so it is not semi-variable here, it is variable cost. The third, rent for the factory, you do not have variable cost, you have only fixed cost, so it is fixed cost. In power, you have variable component as well as fixed component. So it is semi-variable cost. And the last one, you have variable cost and fixed cost. So it is semi-variable cost. You have it is this maintenance. Maintenance is semi-variable cost. So the classification is first one is variable cost. Second one is variable cost. Third one is fixed cost. Fourth one is semi-variable cost and fifth one is also semi-variable cost. So the problem does not end in finding the whether this the classifications. You have to find the total fixed cost and variable cost per unit. You have to total all these things, items of variable cost. This is the total and divided by 1000 is the number of units. So 102 is the variable cost per unit, and this column we have the total, which is the fixed cost. So when you total the variable cost and fixed cost, you will get the total cost. You can recheck that again. So hope you have understood. The last column is corrected, and you can see the sum with the corrected last column here. I want you to do this problem for the next class, and we will verify, and I will clarify the doubts in a live session. Hope we'll have it in next week for clarifying the doubts. If you have, you can please note down if you do not understand. Next is the fourth type of classification, is the classification based on function. What are the functions that are happening in an industry? Can you tell what are the functions that are occurring? I think you will find now. So production is a function in an organization. Can you tell what are the other functions? Hope you have found it right. Production, administration, selling and distribution, R&D are the various functions. We usually do not treat the R&D costs for in finding any product costs, but we will have, but this is one type of classification so that we can not take this R&D costs for product cost calculation. We will use that as some other expenses and deal it under certain heads, but not for the cost sheet. So this classification is very important for understanding cost sheet better. So we have production costs, administrative costs, selling and distribution costs, and R&D costs. So production costs are things that are involved in the factory. So you have a head office somewhere in Bombay and you have your factory at Pune. All, even if you have your factory and in Coimbatore, you have some office and you have a factory, the things which are under factory are called as production costs. Usually they are direct materials which you might, direct labor though who are involved in the manufacture of the product, and other or indirect materials and that are there, that are classified under stores overheads. So all your indirect materials comes under that. So what are the indirect costs that are happening in your factory, like power, maintenance, all indirect, all overheads. Overheads means indirect. So indirect things, indirect expenses that are happening in your production factory is called as production cost. Next comes your administrative costs. Those managers who are formulating the policies, who are directing directors of the organization, and other office related phone, telephone charges, all those things come under your administrative expenses. Next is selling and distribution. After this, you are going to transport your manufactured product so to some central warehouse, or you are paying to some salesman. They are who will see the demand, and you will advertise your products. All those things come under your selling and distribution selling and distribution, mostly it is expenses. And your R&D is for, if it is for a particular product alone, then we can include that, or for a particular process change. But mostly R&D costs are not included in the total cost. So the three main things that are there are production cost, office and administrative cost, and selling and distribution expenses, and that will include the marketing as well. It is a part of that. So now these are the examples for the this is your factory cost, material, labor, factory rent, depreciation of the machine that is used for production, power and lighting, power for the manufacturing machines, and the lighting that is inside the factory, the insurance of the machines, then you insure your factory materials also, like cotton you insure, weaving, you know, fabrics you insure. So those insurance costs are also manufacturing costs or production costs. Here it is also production cost. Stores and keeping, which is there in the factory itself. So these are all examples of production cost. Next is administrative cost. You pay to your accounts, personal, you pay other office expenses, telephone, paper, printers, printing material expenses. Then an auditor comes and audits the financial audit too. Then a person who deal with legal things, the office rent, the director's remuneration, postage, all those things come under your administrative. The letter post, all those things, that postal expenses come under your administrative cost. Next, third, I have said selling and distribution. Both are included in the same one, but for knowing the differences in selling and distribution, it is given here like this. So for selling, you advertise the product, you give commissions per piece basis, or sometimes it may be for this order you are giving some commission of 1% for the salesman. Next, showroom expenses. You sell your product in your own showroom, then you have your showroom expenses. Sampling, sometimes you give free samples, those things are all selling costs. Then the travel expenses of those salesmen are all coming under your selling expenses. Next, distribution expenses. You pack, you keep it in, you have carriage outward, warehouse, you stock it, you produce your materials in Coimbatore, you sell at different locations. So you will have warehouse in certain, you will have a warehouse in Delhi, you will have a warehouse in Bombay, Calcutta, so that you, from there you have your showrooms in various places where you can do the carriage. So those costs are distribution costs, and upkeep and running of cost of delivery when you do door delivery or from warehouse to your showroom, those distribution costs are coming under distribution, selling and distribution expenses. So I hope you have got an idea. This is one another type of classification. And important classification used in cost sheet. So I would introduce cost sheet here, and you will go into the details in the next part of the lecture after completing the classification into cost sheet. But I would like to make a hint, because this type of classification is important in understanding cost sheet better. So the cost sheet has these five components. The first one is prime cost, second is factory or works cost, third is the total cost of production or office cost, fourth is the total cost or cost of sales. See, they have two different terms, total cost of production and total cost, both are different. And the fifth one is the selling price or sales. So the first one, prime cost, includes direct material, direct labor and direct expenses. Now I hope you know the importance of understanding the classification. If you do not classify it rightly under the heads, the basic elements, then you can't understand the other classifications better. So the base classification is based on traceability, direct material, direct labor and direct expenses, which is called as prime cost. And then prime cost plus factory overheads. What are factory overheads? I hope you remember factory overheads are the indirect labor, indirect material and indirect expenses that are occurring in your factory. So this is factory overheads. So prime cost plus, so direct and indirect material, labor and expenses that are happening in the factory are called as factory cost. So prime cost plus factory overheads gives your factory cost, or the other name is works cost. Next, the third is works cost plus office and administrative expenses is your office cost or total cost of production. Your factory total, what are all the costs that are happening in your factory plus your office. The office, it is totally indirect. There is no direct cost because there is no relationship with the product. Office is working for common, so it is all indirect. Office and administrative overheads may be indirect labor, indirect material and indirect expenses, all these that are occurring in the office and administrative, under administrative heads. So that along with your works cost, which you have found as two, this is your two plus this thing, office and administrative overheads, you get the office cost or total cost. The next is the fourth under the cost sheet, which is the office cost plus selling and distribution overheads, which is called as total cost. This is the cost you used for finding the fixing the price of the product. So till this you have to know, and profit you can fix to find the selling price. So office cost plus your selling and distribution expenses is your total cost or cost of sales. So I want you to understand the difference between total cost and total cost of production. Till your office, it is total cost of production. After coming out of the office, it along with selling and distribution expenses is your total cost. This cost is the one which you will use for fixing the cost of a product that is to be sold. So the cost of sales plus profit. This is a common term which you would have used from your school days. Cost plus profit is equal to selling price. Cost plus profit is equal to price. Cost of sales plus profit is equal to selling price or sales. See, in fourth, you have cost of sales. Here the sales. Sales means the price, whereas cost of sales means it does not include profit. So these are the five components of a cost sheet. Components of total cost or components of cost sheet. We will learn in detail on cost sheet after the classification. So this is a picture which explains you better. So this is your prime cost. This is your factory cost, cost of production, cost of sales and sales. So we have seen four different classifications. First, classification based on nature, elemental classification, material, labor and expenses. Second type of classification based on traceability as direct or indirect. Then your third classification, important, based on variability as fixed, variable and semi-variable. Then you have had your fourth classification, which is important for cost sheet, as production cost, yes, office cost, selling and office or administrative, then selling and distribution expenses and R&D expenses. But in the cost sheet you had first prime cost, factory cost, office cost, total cost of production, then you had total cost and the sales. So five components we had in your cost sheet. So the product costs are also called as manufacturing costs or factory costs. The product cost is the cost incurred to make or manufacture a product. It is also known as inventoriable costs. I asked you to find examples, but we'll see the examples here itself. And in period cost, it is the non-manufacturing. After the product is manufactured, what are the costs involved? The office and administrative expenses and selling and distribution expenses are the expenses which are not involved in manufacturing. Even if you manufacture or not, are going to be generated, but maybe it does not have any direct involvement with the factory. So as it is for an accounting period, it is called as period cost. Non-manufacturing cost is a simple terminology. So it is not assigned to a product cost or a period cost, as it is the expenses that occur for a period of time. So the examples for product costs are direct material, direct labor, direct expenses, and factory overheads. And this is what I asked you to find. Hope now it is clear. Then the period costs are administrative overheads and selling and distribution overheads. So this slide also gives the same. This was a hint I thought you will find from this. The direct material, direct expenses, direct labor and manufacturing overheads or factory overheads are examples of product costs. And the factory cost is can be understood in detail when you do the cost sheet, as well as the administrative and selling expenses. The examples are given in cost sheet, which is discussed in your course outcome 2. I have posted the lectures now. So this direct material, direct expenses, direct labor and manufacturing overheads are your product costs. The period costs are only administrative expenses and selling and distributing expenses. The others, the finance cost and other things that are occurring in your office are also called as period costs. So you, from this relationship, I hope you will understand the functional classification as well as the classification based on association with the product. Better understanding will be got when you do the cost sheet. Now the cost sheet is posted, so you will get a better understanding of it when the cost sheet examples are worked out in the course outcome 2. So direct material, direct labor and direct expenses are your prime cost, and prime cost and factory overheads are your factory cost. So factory cost is nothing but your product cost or work cost. So this is your product cost, and after producing the product, to manage for that period, you need to manage that factory. For that, you have an office and administrative people. So the overheads related to office and administration are your period costs, and also the selling and distribution overheads are your period costs. So this is your period cost. Administrative overheads, selling and distribution overheads are your period costs. So if you do not have any inventories, leaving off the stock, your cost of sales minus your factory cost will give your period cost. So the product cost plus period cost gives the cost of sales. Before profit, the cost of sales or the total cost is there. That is a total of your product and period costs. One more type of classification for better understanding. So in this, we have the material consumed is a direct material, and this direct material is there in the factory. So according to functional classification, it is prime cost, and according to association with the product, it is called as product cost. So we can see here all your prime and factory overheads are your product costs in this example discussed in lecture 6. And so materials, productive wages, direct expenses, stores consumable, oil and lubrication that is occurring in the factory, salary of factory manager is a factory overhead, that is indirect labor, unproductive wages, indirect labor, factory rent factory overhead, then your repair and depreciation of the machine. All these are occurring in the factory, then it is a product cost. And that which is occurring in the distribution, sell the administration and office and selling and distribution are your period costs. Hope you have understood the product and the period cost. The period cost is only the administrative expenses, office expenses and selling and distribution expenses. Hope the difference between product and period costs are clear now.